A QR code is a two-dimensional barcode. They've been around since 1994 when they were invented by a company in Japan called Denso Wave. QR codes are huge in Japan. Apparently they're everywhere. I've never been to Japan, but I've heard they're everywhere. Packaging, you'll have a QR code. You know, you pick up a bag of lettuce at the supermarket. There's actually a QR code on the bag of lettuce you can capture, and it'll tell you when that lettuce was harvested, where it was harvested, all sorts of information. One of the best uses of a QR code in an educational setting is what I would call additional information. So, like, you might have a lecturer in a university or a TAFE who delivers a PowerPoint presentation, and at the end of it, there might be a QR code, or there might be a series of QR codes which provide you with more information about the subject matter. So it might be, for example, if the lecturer has a Delicious account, which is, you know, he or she has a lot of additional links, you know, further reading about that subject, then rather than giving it to you, you know, you grab a piece of paper as you go out the door with all of that information on it. I mean, then you've got to type it all in. If you've got the information in the form of a QR code, you can just get into his or her Delicious account and then just go for it. You could have a QR code providing you with information about instructions about how to use that particular piece of technology, or how to use that, how to operate a piece of machinery in a factory, that kind of thing. He wanted to make it fun for his students, so he created QR codes which give you the names of different parts of the bodies. He put them on the skeleton in the wrong places, so the students had to decode them. They get, like, I don't know, the text coming up saying fibia, and then they've got to put it on that particular part of the body. That makes learning fun. I mean, you know, it doesn't have to be that way. You could just provide them with the information, but doing it like that, it's kind of an adventure, you know. In terms of QR codes, I said that there's still a lot of work to be done. QR codes, there are a lot of barriers at the moment. The number one barrier being the technology, followed closely by the cost.